Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to continue right now the competition, which is Egypt versus Hungary. So I'm asking both teams to come here for the national anthem.
Here we go. The first big international event in Egypt, Supernova Fight League. The big show have arrived. Hungary against Egypt. Two nations will both have a representative team fighting each other for the honor of the nation. Here is Team Egypt entering the ring. I'm your host, Danny Hoving. The national flags. It's an amazing show. It will be an amazing night of fights. Here is the Hungarian team. Waiting to enter the ring. Cairo Stadium. Here they enter. Greeting the audience. The biggest show of Africa. Fighters testing the ring. Feeling the canvas.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I request from you to all stand up for the national Hungarian anthem. And then stand up for the Egyptian national anthem as well. Would you please stand up? Would you please stand up? Would you please stand up? Play the music.
Such an honor for these young warriors. When the national anthem plays, it energizes you. The applause, the respect.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up to
like
the national Hungarian anthem. And now we are going to play the Egyptian national anthem. Would you please rise and stand up?
Egypt. Under the big lights. The Egyptian warriors waited for this. A big stage where they can show their skills. The applause. The audience loves it. But before we go to the international event 4 against 4, we'll have two amazing international super fights. Two Turkish warriors have came.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is 3 3-minute rounds in the flyweight division, 51 kilograms. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Ahmed Ismail. And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Mohammed Musa. Bakıp Türk'ün bayrağına çırpınırdım Karadeniz. Bakıp Türk'ün bayrağına.
Here we go with the first international super fight. Turkish warrior Mohammed Musa making his pro debut against the captain of the national amateur team from the good heel kick. From the national amateur team, Ahmed Ismail, also making his pro debut. They're matched up very close. Both of them finding their range. Good jab by Ahmed Ismail. Good hook by Mohammed Musa. Starting in a high pace. No clinching allowed in the supernova. Ahmed Ismail light on his feet. Mohammed Musa taking the center of the ring. Good feint knee with a punch combination by Ahmed Ismail. A good hook. Good check hook. Very intelligent fighter. Oh, it's a good hook. Good combination. He heard him. He heard Mohammed Musa. Well seen by the referee, well seen. First 8 count. Ahmed Ismail getting last instruction from his team. Let's see how Mohammed Musa recovered. His hands are up high. Another flurry. Good punches, but Ahmed Ismail is swinging away to trying to finish the fight. Well defended by Mohammed Musa. Oh. Good sportive behavior. You see your first heavy breathing of Ahmed Ismail. His explosions trying to finish the... Oh, good heel kick. Nice. Good body shot. Second 8 count. What I was saying, these explosions, they take a lot of power. Trying to finish the fight, but now it's 2 knockdowns. The crowd is loving it. 2 knockdowns in a round. If you do 1 more, 3 knockdowns in a round, it's end of the fight. So 1 more knockdown, it will, and Ahmed Ismail will win by knockout. Technical knockout, how we call this. Mohammed Musa taking the center of the ring again. Need to keep in the ring. End of the round. Mohammed Musa survived. He can recover. Start the second round. Let's see what the strategic instructions were. If something will change. Let's see how well Mohammed Musa recovered. Taking the center of the ring again. I see Ahmed Ismail waiting to counterattack. Good high kick. Crowd is enjoying the show. Finally, they will have their big international stage for the fighters to shine on. The Egyptians have been waiting long for this. Now it's finally here. Supernova bringing a big stage to Egypt. Good hook by Mohamed Moussa. Good combination, Ahmed Ismail swinging away. Heavy breathing again. His guard is dropping. Lactic acid. Good combination. Good footwork by Ahmed Ismail. Scored 2 knockdowns the first round. That means a 10-7 round. Good push kick. Good timing. Oi, good hook by Mohamed Moussa. Cutting off the ring. He needs to hurt Ahmed Ismail. Took a 10-7 round the first round. Oi, good hook. Good punch. Did he hurt Ahmed Ismail there? If he wins 2 rounds only with points, it's not enough. Because 10-7 round, it means if you win 2 rounds with a 2-9, you're still 1 point short. You can see the explosions from Ahmed Ismail, they took his toll. Another good check hook by Mohamed Moussa. Trying to press the action, try to pressure Ahmed Ismail in working hard to empty the tank. Good combination by Ahmed Ismail, good dodge work. Here we go, 3rd round. Ahmed Ismail leading in point because of the double knockdown in the first round. Good comeback by Mohamed Moussa in the second round. It shows the skill of a warrior when you get knocked down twice and you can win the round after it. Very good heart by the young Turkish warrior. Pressing the action again. He knows he needs to do something this round. And he don't have his good heel kick. A little bit off in the timing with the high kick. Their coach could not come the last day. The PCR test did not come through. So the fighters came alone. They're being supported by the Hungarian team. So they don't have their original coach. But they're still here. Fighting. He needs to pressure. He's behind on points. You can put your hands up because you feel he's fainting, but you need to hurt him, kid. Go for it. Good combination by Ahmed Ismail. Yes, you can put your hand up, but you need to hurt him. Everybody knows he's fainting and you need to do something with it. It's experience. It's experience also though. It's a learning process, good kick. They're both making their professional debut. They're very good, skillful amateur fighters. But the pros is different. Good combinations. Every fight they make, they'll get better. Yeah, work for it, kid. Don't put your hands up. You need to hurt them. You're behind them points. Ahmed Ismail, very smart fighter, moving away. No, he's in front of points. Using footwork, not to get hurt, not to get locked up in a corner. Good low kick. Scoring his points. Moving away, using timing. Missed on an upcut there. Turkish fighter needs pressure now. Oh, he will lose this fight on points. You need to hurt Ahmed Ismail to win this. A very close fight. Very competitively matched. He should cut the ring off. Good footwork by Ahmed Ismail again. End of the fight, end of the round. Very good match. The first international match of the Supernova Fight League. So let's go to the judges.
Let me announce, the winner is Red Corner.
Yes, it was close. I agree, Ahmed Ismail won the fight because of the knockdowns here, the highlights, the slip, another slip. Good punch by Mohamed Moussa. Here's the heel kick on the body, yes. Amazing fight. Good comeback from Ahmed.
The following is for the Bantamweight World Championship. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Mai Abdel Ali.
World title fight. Bantamweight, 57 kilo, Mai representing Egypt, fighting Suna Demir from Turkey.
And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Suna Demir.
Here's the belt.
One knee, no clinch, okay?
The first Supernova World title fight. Here we go with the first round. Both ladies representing the best of the best from their country. Good push kick by Mai. Good opening. It was a slip, no 8 count. Checking everything in order. The action starts again. Good punch by Suna. Good check hook by Mai. Audience is loving it. Finally Supernova came, bringing high level fights to Egypt. Oh, good check hook again by Mai with a big smile. The psychological games have begun. Mental warfare is a big part in the kickboxing sport. Another good check hook by Mai, very good. Very good timing. Suna trying to press the action. Need to find the rhythm and timing. Another good check hook. And another big smile, yes. Another good check hook. Very good timing by Mai. She's winning the beginning of the fight with the check punches. Good footwork by Suna. Another big smile by Mai. Another good competitive fight. Supernova bringing the action. Attempt to back fist, hit the shoulder. Return of the back fist. good exchange by these ladies. Good hook by Mai. Good footwork. Another good check hook by Mai. Letting Suna walk into the punches. Very smart, very good timing. Good knee by Suna, and again another good check punch by Mai. Balance, no 8 count. Well seen by the referee. Very high level fight. Very competitive ladies. Good counter by Mai again. End of the first round. In my eyes, the first round was for Mai. Second round starts. Let's see if the strategy changes. The instruction of the coach can always be a lot. On the other hand, the Turkish fighters don't have their own coach with it. Another big smile by Mai, enjoying what she does best. Another good counter. Good combination. Another good hook by Mai. Starting off strong this round also. Good combination by Mai. Suna trying to bring the action. Opening a lot with kicks. Maybe she change it up. Start with punches and then kick. Making it easy for Mai to counter her. That's a good kick. First good timing. A good counter. Audience is loving it. Another attempt for a back fist. Oh, good flurry by Mai. Well defended. Good action. Oei. Swing and a miss. Oh, there goes the referee. Nothing going on. Referee's a warrior too. Good check. That's a good jab by Suna. Again, only opening with a kick. She to work her hands first and then finishing with a kick. Change this combination up. Makes her less predictable. Again, opening with a kick. Good by Mai. Good check hook again. Finishing with a kick. Good punches by Mai, good knee. Her timing is just a little bit better. These ladies are very competitively matched. But the timing of Mai has just given her the edge in this fight. Another good timing, good punch by Mai. Suna looking for openings. You see here reading. The young Turkish warrior. End of second round. Both rounds go to Mai in my book. So Suna need to do something special this round. If she wants to take home the title. Good check hook by Mai and then another big smile again. Enjoying what she does. Again opening with a kick. Just swing and a miss by Mai. Good knee by Suna. Very professional. Only one knee in the clinch. That's why these ladies are fighting for a world title. They're the highest level. grappling with the kick again. And again, it makes it so easy to be countered. It's also a learning process. These ladies are young, have a long career ahead, fighting in a high level fight already. Finding out who's the world champion, who could go home with the belt. Both of them is the first fight in a big organization. So the high level competition, the audience, the big stadium, it could bring some jibbers. A little bit instruction by the referee, they need to listen. Stop is stop, fight is fight. Another good check punch by Mai. Her timing is really bringing the edge. Good footwork. Oh, good punch by Mai. Young ladies giving everything they got. It's for a world title, that's why all the fighters in the kickboxing sport training hard. They're dreaming about fighting for a title in a big organization. So today both of them, they can fulfill a dream. They're going for it. Good hook by Mai again. What's out the hair? Referee needs a little extra work with the hair. Blocking her vision. Good sidekick by Mai. Keeping her distance like this. Good hook. Soon I need to do something special to win this fight. She's behind on points. Mai edged her the whole fight. Good check hook again. Mai waiting for Suna to come. She knows she's ahead on points. End of the third round. End of this championship fight. Good action. High level fight here in Supernova, Egypt. Yes, Mai takes home the gold. The timing was better. Good competitive fight. Respect for the Turkish warrior. Some highlights of the fight. It was the check kick. Good side kick. Good punch exchange.
And the following is three rounds in the super welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Mahmoud Gama. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Johnny Mate.
Here's the Hungarians. The party can get started. They're starting at dancing. Egypt against Hungary is a fact. The first fight of the night. Who will open the score? Johnny Mate in red. Mahmoud Gamal in the yellow trunks. This is their chance. On a big stage. You can see it. They start with a high pace. It's always something different in a big organization. They're going for it. They're not even fighting only for a big organization. They're fighting with the honor of their country. So it brings the pressure up even more. They started to respect each other a little bit more. You see, the reading has started. Oh, good block by Mahmoud Damal. Very powerful punches. A very good record. Johnny Mate, very experienced. His experience against power. Crazy flying technique. Experienced or not, everything changes under the big lights from a big show. Mahmoud Gamal swing away, trying to land that power hand. Oh, there, oh, nice. Good body shot right under a punch. When you're punching your body, it's not a shield. He waves it off. Is it a knockout? He raises his hand. A little bit confusion about what's going on. Is it a knockout? Is it a technical knockout? He did stand in time, but the referee did wave it off. Will they keep fighting? Will they announce a winner? Give John, I think he will give him another chance. Yeah, they will keep fighting. They will keep fighting. First knockdown for Egypt. Another shot to the body and it's finished. It's finished, yes, referee. 1-0 for Egypt. Mahmoud Gamal with the first round knockout. This kid has very, very much power in his hands. It was a little bit of a confusion at first.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 33 seconds of the very first round, the winner by TKO from Egypt, Mahmoud Gamal!
Mahmoud Gamal opens the score. Egypt's in front. 1-0. Here's the highlights. Let's see what happened. I think it was a right hand to the body. There we go, yes, he turned into the punch, right on the ribs. Here's the second one.
We continue the competition. Egypt versus Hungary in the following 3 3-minute rounds in the super welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, Zsolt Kaszonka.
Zsolt Kaszonka, amateur boxing champion of Hungary. Very talented kid.
Out of the blue corner, Tariq Ashraf.
Supernova Fight League.
Fighting Tariq Ashraf, Muay Thai fighter. Big chance for him. Round number one. Here we go. Zsolt Kaszonka with the red gloves. Tariq Ashraf, the black. Trying to press the action with the kicks. He's a Muay Thai fighter. Taking on a boxer in kickboxing rules. That's a nice kick. Powerful kick landed by Tariq Ashraf. Trying to swing with a head kick. Attempt for a back fist. Two knees, not allowed. You can make only one technique when you clinch. Very firm decision by the referee, but fair. A rule is a rule. Not taking none. Zsolt Kaszonka with evasive footwork. Good low kick by Tariq. An Another swing and a miss for a high kick. Good low kick again. Soltsonka trying to find his range, moving in and out. Good punches there. And again, let him miss with a high kick. These big swings and a miss, they will take a lot from your energy tank. Good footwork by Soltsonka. A little bit clinchy. Tarek Ashraf is a Muay Thai fighter. He's used of clinching if somebody comes close. So in the pro league with the kickboxing, you need to change his game. No warning for Zolt for clinching. Referee Zeynep is not having none. Good punches by Zolt. Again, good punches. Landing a clean strike. Did he hurt him there? I think he did. Putting the pressure on it. I think he might have hurt Tarek Ashraf. Tarek stopped moving. Again. Clinches. Of course he got hurt. Trying to take some seconds to recover. Good body punch by Zolt. Here we go again. Pressing the action. Fight your way out of the clinch. Again, a big swing and a high kick. Miss. Tarek need to time his shots better. But Soltsonka also is not making it easy with his good footwork. Moving in and out like this. Another big high kick miss. It will take a lot of energy when you miss these big shots. Soltsonka is starting to land and land more. Clean strikes. Good crisp technique. Missing flying technique. Good footwork by Zolt, moving in and out. Timing his shots very carefully. See another big gasp of air with Tarek Ashraf. Swinging a miss, body shot. That was a good punch. Again ending up in the clinch. You see him taking the underhooks from the Muay Thai clinch. It just reflexes because he fought a lot of Muay Thai fights. These reflexes are in your system. Good body shot by Zolt. Good kicks. None. Again, these small shots, they hitting the target. They're not big shots, but if you keep landing, they will hurt. They will add up. Not a good jab. Good boxing work from the national boxing champion from Hungary. He's trying to equal the score. He's 1-0 behind and Hungary is. So all the pressure is on Zolt. No sweeps allowed. Good firm. The referee is very good. Don't give these fighters any space of doing shots that are not allowed. Good evasive movement by Tarek. Again, swing and a miss. He missing a lot of techniques that will cost a lot of power. Soltsonka moving in and out, hitting the target with very crisp shots. Again, good check hook, good upcut. You can see Tarek's energy tank is fainting. Looking for the clinch. End of the round. respect by these fighters, very good. Respect a big, big thing in this sport. Final round. One round for Zolt, one close round. So it's still there for the taking for both these fighters. Who wants it more? Fighting for the honor of your nation. Supernova Fight League bringing the action. Good exchanges by these warriors. Pace going up. High pace fight. Zolt Zonka leaning the cleanest strikes again. Good timing. The footwork and the timing is edging him now, the fight. All these swinging and misses, these big high kicks. Tarek Ashiraf tried to make. They're starting to take his toll on him now, you can see it. Being effective with your punches and kicks, with your energy, is so important on a big stage. Good knee. You can see that the speed is going down from Tarek. Zolt still having same explosiveness like the first round. He's punching, he's a boxer, so it doesn't compromise the system a lot. He's doing what he used to. Good low kick. Good punches. Good punches by Tarek Ashiraf. Good body punch. But then again, looking for the clinch. Time to take a big breath of air. Song trying to press the action. Another big swing and a miss by Tarek Ashiraf. Yes. Good warning by the referee. Another point reduction, but letting the fighter know, don't clinch extensively. Zolt is pressing the action. He's feeling Tarek fainting. He knows the third round is important for the scorecard. Zolt keeping the center of the ring. Pressing Tarek against the ropes. Tarek stopped moving. He should not let himself be pushed up the ropes like that. Another spinning back fist. Good short hook. Low kick. Zolt is turning up the pressure. Leaning the cleanest strikes. End of the fight. Good fight. These young warriors gave everything.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards, and the winner by unanimous decision from Hungary, Zolt Gosonka!
Respect between the fighters, very important. Zolt took the victory. It's a little bit cleaner with the strikes, a little bit more effective with his energy. Good footwork, good clean bunching. Good body kick there by Tarek. Illegal sweep.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue the competition between Egypt and Hungary with three-minute rounds in the welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Abdullah Mando,
one of the most experienced fighters of Egypt.
And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, David Kinhefner.
Fighting the big talent of David Kinhefner. His talent against experience. Let's see. Would take the charge again. It's 1-1. Egypt 1 point. Hungary 1 point. Here we go, start of the match. Good block by Abdul Amando. Big smile on his face. He knows it's finally time. It's finally here. The Egyptians finally have a big stage to shine on, to show their skills in. Big international opponent. Things just don't get any better than this for these young warriors. Wild clinch. Referee warning them not to clinch. Only moving forward. When you're at the close point, you should move backwards a little bit. You can let your hands do the work. Good combination by David. Good heel kick. Abdul Amanda just got out of the way in time. Another good combination by David. Big smile by Abdul Amando again. Good knee, good kick. I like this. This kid is loving this. Good timing on a low kick. Good high kick. Oh, what's that? I think he kicked a knee. He damaged his foot. Oh, there is the towel from the Hungarians. It might have been an old injury.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 50 seconds of the very first round, the winner by TKO due to injury, Abdullah Mando!
Egypt takes the lead again, it's 2-1. All pressure is on the final fight with the double points. Let's see what happened. Good timed low kick here by Abdul Amando. Good punch. Heel kick. Let's see what happens. Good high kick. Yes, he hit the knee with his foot. I hope there's nothing serious with the injury.
Event of the evening. Three rounds in the welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Abdullah Nagy.
And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 51 wins and 8 losses and 1 draw. He stands 178 centimeters tall, weighing at 67.5 kilos.
Here we go, main event, last fight of the night. The victories both still for the taking. The championship fight takes double points. So Egypt's are in front of it 2-0. But if Hungary wins this match, they can still win the international fight night. Start with a high pace. Oh, good hook by Abdullah Nagy. Two talented youngsters. Fighting for a world title. International event in Egypt. Good low kick. Abdullah Nagy. High pace. Abdullah Nagy with good pressure. He's a very explosive fighter. He's showing it off. Good counters by Laszlo Farkas. These kids, they're very talented. Very skillful fighters. Fighting for a world title, fighting for the honor of their nation. Pressure is on them. Good combination. Again, finish with a low kick. Laszlo Fagas using footwork to avoid explosive power up of Abdullah Nagy. Good low kick, good timing. Again, good low kick. Good timing. It doesn't get any better than this. Nice combination, good knee, it was in the guard. Good pressure. Good low kick again. This kid is so strong, so explosive. Good combination, yes, finishing with a kick. They're very close. Good skill level, good knee. So it's the little details that are gonna make the difference. Who has the better strategic game plan? Who had a better preparation in camp? Good low kick, a good hook. Nice counter with a heel kick. Good knee again by Nutu. Good knees. It's always long fighters have good knees. There's two knees, not allowed. In the clinch, you can only make one knee. Well seen by the referee. Makes an official warning. Very good work by the referee. Good low kick, balance. End of the first round, tensions are high. Second round, here we go. Respect with the hand touch, very important. Good block by Abdullah Nagy. First round obviously went to him. But Nutu is making his combinations. Laszlo Farkas, his nickname is Nutu. One of the biggest talents of Hungary. Get a groin shot, keeps going like a warrior. Starting to get in his game. Finding his distance, opening his combinations. Good knee again, good air action reactions. Very high level fight. Attempt flying knee. Good combination again by Laszlo Farkas. Keep countering, action reaction work, very high level fight. Supernovas bringing the action. Good low kick, good knee. So competitive. Another good knee. This one hits. Yes, you saw it. He feels it. Yep. It was in the groin. Gives him a chance to recover. Even if you're wearing a cup, fighters, they know. You see damage from the knee that hit on the nose. Give the fighters a chance to breathe. Good opening from the round from Laszlo Farkas. You know he lost the first round. So if you lose two rounds in a three-round fight, it will be difficult to win. So he's putting up the pace. He's trying to score the points back. Intelligent young man. Having a big chance. Fighting for a big organization for a world title. Another continent, good combinations. Again, good knee, good combination. Using his distance, it's a long rangey fighter. You see Abdullah Nagy fading a little bit. Could be of the knees, could be of the explosive work in the first round. You never know what's going on, maybe a good knee again, good touch. He should start pressuring again. He had a lot of success pressuring Farkas against the ropes. And he stopped the pressure. End of second round. Now it's 1-1 in rounds. They both won a round. So here the third round. Who wins this round, wins the fight, wins the title. Make their country win the international event. So all the pressure is on this round. Supernova bringing the action. Competitive fights, international stage. Cairo National Stadium. Abdullah Nagy is again letting Laszlo Farkas using his reach and his range to pick him apart. He should pressure him like, oh, balance moment, good block by Abdullah Nagy. He should pressure him when he putting the fighter backwards, a rangy fighter backwards, he cannot attack. But when you let him come forward, he will pick you apart with range and reach. He should do what he did in the first round. Put his back against the rope like this, yes, pressuring. You see, oh, good counters, good knees again. But Laszlo Farkas, this work, yes. Going forward. Not allowing Nutu to use his footwork. Almost hit him there with a crazy overhand. They're very close. This round is very close, you see it. Both having success. They feel the tension. It's about a world title. It's about the honor of your country. These kids are doing everything. Big breath from Abdullah Nagy. Maybe it was the knees, maybe it was the explosive work of the first round. Almost hit him with a heel kick. Well defended by Abdullah Nagy. Very competitive fight. They're very close. Now is the question, who wants it more? Who wants to take home the leather belt? Who wants to be the world champion? Oh, this could score heavy. Point reduction. Keep going with the action. Nice combination by Abdullah Nagy. Good combination by Nutu. Did he hurt him there? You saw a moment of balance. Kicked in the block. This fight is so close. Nice spinning back fist. Blocked by Abdullah Nagy. Good knee work again by Nutu. He's dropping his hands. He also feeling the hard work. The competitive fight. It's hard to see. First round. Obviously for Nagy, second round for Nutu, third round was so close. I hate to be a judge, it's an extra round. It was too close to score. So one more round to see who's gonna be the world champion and which country will take the win. Which country will take the trophy and the leather belt. Can feel the tension. So much to win, so much to lose. Good low kicks, good action reaction moments, good overhand. This is what he should do, Abdullah Nagy. Pressure him with his back against the ropes, like this. Good punch combination. Good low kick, good knee by Nutu. And then again, good knee. He's really scoring with it. And again. Oh, just missed. Big hook. Again, very close fight. Close round. Hard to score. The question is, who wants it more? Good combination by Laszlo Farkas. Good heel kick. Abdullah misses his punches. Good knee by Nuttu. Good high kick. Nuttu starting to score the points. Just a little quicker, just a little fitter. Overhand by Abdullah Nagy, just missed. Trying to force the knockout. Last minute to take it all. Missed again. Oh, good high kick. Good back fist in the guard. Nuttu starting to score points. Too much trainers in the corner. Only two trainers. Last chance for these fighters to force the victory. See what country will win today. Will it be Egypt? Will it be Hungary? Another good high kick by Nuttu. Good combinations. He's finishing strong. He's finishing strong. That could be what makes the difference today. Keeps working. End of the fight. Gives a little elbow to the referee. Accidents, these things can happen. Such close fight. I think the strong finish of Nuttu might have given the edge. But so competitive. They were so close to each other. Main event of the Supernova Fight League. Everything to win, everything to lose.
The champion of this match is Hungarian.
Yes. Hungary takes it. Egypt fought well. The first big international event. They fought, here's the highlights. They fought very strong opponents from Hungary. They were very equally matched. Egypt can go home with their head held up high. They fought for it. It was an amazing night, the fights.